And it's welcome to the top three finishing drivers in the indoor European Championships for touring cars. The winner and European champion is Ronald Volker. In second, it's Christer Hansen. And in third, Mark Reinhardt. Ronald, I'm struggling to think of anything to say apart from well done. That must be a perfect weekend for you.
It was a perfect weekend. The car was perfect, prepared by Umino, my mechanic, and yeah.
So without your mechanic, do you still think you would have won?
I don't know. It is really a lot. It helped me a lot that I got help from Giacomo and especially from Umino. And yeah, I don't know if I would have been that fast with my preparation.
Now, it's interesting that Giacomo are making a big push now, aren't they, in Europe, and you're spearheading this. Is that support from Japan very important?
Especially for me, as my mechanic skills are not that good, it's really important for me, and I hope Giacomo improve in Europe, and they sell a lot of cars, and then more people going to one Giacomo.
Going into the two races, because you only did two, when you were out in front, were you going as fast as you could go, or were you just controlling the pace and looking for that easy win?
Especially in the first main, I got a lot of pressure off Mark, so I had to drive as best as I can, and it was close to the end. So, in the second main, the car was perfect, better than in the first main. It was, I think, the best one of the car this weekend, and yeah.
Christer, you are the vice European champion. That must be particularly nice for you, considering it's your hometown.
Yeah, I think this is very nice and a very pleasure for me to be vice European champion, even though I was looking for the win, but this is where we are.
You won the final leg, and it seemed, was it just you got a better start because you were at the front? Because you seemed much happier in that third leg than you had done in the previous two legs, as far as the car was concerned.
Well, I changed the car a little bit, and it was much better, more consistent, and more easier to drive.
Now, in the first leg, you got away second, and in the third corner, you had an accident and went down the field. What went through your mind as your car was rolling over?
Well, I was a little bit confused in the beginning, and after that it was quite trouble all the way to the end, but yeah.
Mark, I'll be honest with you, I'm not used to interviewing you when you're not first.
Yeah, but it happens. I mean, all the drivers in A-Main are almost on the same level, so sometimes this guy wins, sometimes the other guy, and I think it's pretty normal.
You didn't seem very happy with the car yesterday at all. The car, to me, actually looked better today. You just had to get through traffic. What did you do overnight?
Actually, I didn't change so much. I just went a little bit softer shocker, but just a little bit. And yeah, new sets of tyres for the finals. So maybe in the tyres were some small differences. And yeah, in the qualifying, I was pretty upset because it was just like 5/10 off almost in the fastest lap. But yeah, it was better now today in the finals, but still, I mean, from fourth it's always hard to overtake because the track is pretty tight, so you have to wait for a mistake from the other person. But I was lucky in the first main that I could pass Alex in the start and that Christer Kreis, so I was second. But in the second main it was almost impossible.
Is it very frustrating when you've got a car that's now quick enough to run with Ronald that you just can't get past people?
Yeah, but this is racing. I mean, if the qualifying is not good, then you cannot do anything in the final if you're on fourth or fifth, if the track is pretty tight. But I mean, I'm happy that I finished on the podium because yesterday it looked not so good. So I didn't thought about winning the Euros this year after the qualifying.
Well, this really is the high point of the indoor season. But of course, we have an outdoor season coming up, and a very important date for all of you, and you specifically, is the World Championships now held in your home country. What are your preparations between now and July?
I think when we go to the outdoor season in May, I think we are going to test a lot there or on other tracks to get well prepared. And of course, it's the goal of many people to be on the top of the World Championship. So this is the focus for this year.
Well, of course, you were runner-up last time, so you only had to go one better and you'd be a World Champion and European Champion.
Yeah, but it's hard, very hard to get to stay on the top level on any races, on every races. So, I don't know, we'll see how it works in 4 months, 5 months.
Well, with the trophies given out here, that's it from our coverage from Finland, and we hope you enjoyed our coverage from Mäntsälä. But we're back next week with coverage of both European Championships in 112, which are taking place in Hinckley in England, and that's from Friday next week on EFRA.ws. Thanks for watching.